Hello everyone, it's Farkad here, and in this video I'm going to show you how to build an archer bunker or a prison trap using the wood targets. Now how this works is that it prevents them from jumping over it, and this includes the cannibals and the larger mutants, though not all mutants. It can be used either way, to keep them in or to keep them out, which can be very good for, say, a treehouse, or if you're looking to defend your base and you don't want to have to deal with attacks. Of course, you can always disable destruction mode, but if you don't want to do that, here's a way you can get around it. Now, first I'm going to cover the archer bunker. I don't know if I should be calling it the archer bunker, but, well, it's going to be best used as an archer bunker because you can shoot them without them hitting you. It probably wouldn't work too well as a melee. So the idea is that you go in a clockwise direction, because when you rotate, it works much better when you're going clockwise. Otherwise, it will rotate the other way and it'll be very annoying to build. So all you have to do is place a target and then place another one in the exact same spot. That's all you have to do. If there's only one, cannibals can jump it. If there's two, they cannot jump it. Only one's needed to stop mutants, though you want to be able to stop them all. Cannibals never used to be able to jump the target, but then they made them able to jump the target after they see my video of the prison trap. So this prison trap idea still works. You just have to double place the target. And it's quite a cost-effective wall, because a target is only one log and four sticks. Two logs and eight sticks is required for one small segment, which is going to cost you about the same amount as a defensive wall. Also, they will fight each other because they try to get to you and attack you. They end up hitting each other. So it works very well. It's a good way to practice your headshots too, if you're terrible like me. Now for the prison trap, you've got to reverse it, place it the other way around, and then it works like a ramp. Then they'll be able to get in, but they can't get out. Make sure you face it the right way for what you're doing. While I was making this video, I accidentally placed it the wrong way a couple of times, just not paying attention. Now here I'm just making a basic wall that floats, and that way I can climb up on top of it and see if it will lure them in. Now it doesn't lure them in too well, though it does protect me. They don't come close enough. I think if it was a lot bigger, they would. You could always come up here and provoke them. So what the slingshot's good for is pissing them off so they can't attack you. But while I was up there, they wouldn't come up. Though, you can provoke them to go in. On the early days of the game, they don't hate you so much, so they're much less likely to go into the trap or attack you. The later stages of the game is best to do this, because they hate you much more and they want to kill you more. It can be quite difficult to get them in there, though it depends what you're trying to do. If you just want to get half in there and kill the rest that are floating about, that's probably the best way. If you're trying to get a whole family in there, it's going to be very difficult. It's going to take a while. Now, you can get mutants in there as well. This includes the Virginia and the Armsy. The cowman just charges straight out, and you see the Armsy just knocked out my basic wall rope thing. Now, the Armsy can kind of glitch out. Usually when he does his triple attack, he can glitch out, so don't stand around too long. He will eventually escape. Though I thought this actually might give the catapult a use, because the things are basically useless and rocks are cheap. Though, as you can see here, he escaped and took out my catapult very quickly, so don't stuff around too much. It was quite hard to get him back in there, though eventually you can. Virginias can jump into it, but they can't jump out of it. It's like that initial jump, they need to be able to clear that stage right in front of their legs. However, cowmen just run straight in and out of it. They're not fazed by it. As for the bunker trap, they kind of get blocked out, but not at the same time. This one by himself, he wasn't able to figure it out. Though, when I made a few more, they easily got in. You won't encounter this many, probably two at max. Which is a good thing, because if there's more than two, you can get stun locked. Though, if you place a basic wall with a rope, a floating one, you could sit up here and shoot them from a distance, and they won't be able to get you, and they'll just run around in circles underneath you, stomping and carrying on like they do. And just for fun, I'll spawn in crocodiles, and every time they charge or stomp, they explode animals. I don't know if that interests you, but I thought it was funny. And just to let you know, the girl mutant that spawns after you finish the game where you continue playing, that can just step over it, but it can't damage it. However, the worm can damage it. The worm can pretty much damage everything in the game regardless, unless you've got building destruction mode off. Stupid thing. But don't let it near your trap. And just a side note that certain buildings have different render distances. Defensive walls have a fairly large radius, meaning if you're far away, the game will still render as it's in the game. Though after a certain distance, structures start disappearing, which means that it will no longer act as a wall. Because the game's got to get rid of assets, otherwise the game will start running like crap. If it's not getting rid of anything that's loaded in, everything loaded at the same time will cause frames to drop too much. And I think targets don't have a very long range, but keep that in mind. I don't know what range the targets have. Don't rely on it to act as a wall like 400 meters away from your base. I think that's about two or three football fields for you Americans. So there you go. So it turns out cannibals can jump it, only if it's one thing. If there's multiple on top of each other, they can't jump it. They collide with the next one. So it seems to register as that they can only jump one object. You can space them apart if you want, though it's not necessary. Anyway, if you like this video, make sure you like and subscribe. Cheers.